Good morning, friends. Before starting my YouTube video series on international taxation, first of all, I introduce myself. My name is Bipul Kumar, business consultant, working with a team of the lawyers, chartered accountants, and company secretaries. The purpose of making our educational video series is to share knowledge among professionals, lawyers, chartered accountants, company secretaries, cost and management accountants, and other MBA finance professionals, and a student of all professional courses. Apart from this audience group, business persons or houses having international transaction or international trade, non-resident remitting funds, dealing in immovable property, remitting fund inside or outside, or doing any financial transaction in India, they can understand the tax implication on this transaction on the basis of the knowledge shared in this videos. In the introduction session, I categorize my all video series in three categories. Level 1 video, this is our view of the concept. This is very useful for the professionals or a student who is appearing in the examination. In refreshing or encapsulating the all concept in very short term period. Level 2 video is the legal interpretation. It is a detailed analysis of the all legal provisions. Level 3 video covers practical issues and latest amendment by notification, circular, finance acts, case law, and changes in international laws. Dear friends, today I am starting non-resident taxation. This is the first chapter of my YouTube video series. Friend, today we have very short time. We understand the concept of non-resident. Why we need to define non-resident? Is it necessary for taxability to define non-resident? In non-resident taxation, there is a specific provision which covers non-resident taxation. As per Indian laws, the residential status of a person determine a scope of the income included in total income, which is subject to income tax in India. The provision for determining the residential status of a person covered in the income tax provisions. There we see, as per Section 6 of the Income Tax Act, residential status, condition of the residential status, additional condition of the residential status, category of the residential status. Today, we see the definition of non-resident. Who is the non-resident? In general, we classify residential status in broad category resident and not ordinary resident. As per Income Tax Act, resident means non-resident means a person who is not a resident. And for the purpose of section 92, 90 and 168 includes a person who is not ordinary resident within the meaning of the clause 6 of section 6. It means first we determine the status as per section 6, who is the resident, if he did not satisfy the condition mentioned in the section 6 of residential status, then classify as a non-resident. Means a non-resident means a person who is not a resident as per the legal provisions. And for certain provision of the section of income tax, section 92, 93, 168, the person non-resident also include the not ordinary resident. As per section 92, this deals computation of income from international tax transactions having regard to arm length price. Dear friends, international transaction means a transaction between two or more persons or enterprises, either or both of whom are non-resident. At least one is the non-resident. In this case, not ordinary resident is considered as the non-resident. In section 93, avoidance of income tax by transfer of asset resulting in transfer of income to non-resident, for this purpose not ordinary residence is considered as non-resident. And as per section 168, determination of the residential status of executor depending on the residential status of deceased person. In this case, not ordinary residence is also considered as non-resident. My dear friends, the person is non-resident, so when then we check, first we check section 6 basic conditions. This is based on the number of day a stay in India, some additional condition. On that basis we are considered whether is a resident, ordinary resident or not ordinary resident. Exception covered in the section 6. Section 6 recently changed by the Finance Act 2020, which changed the rules, number of day a stay in India for citizen of India or Indian origin person. Here the mention the word 60 days or more in the preceding financial year in previous years, or 65 days or more in preceding four previous years. So the number of days 60 days is substituted by 120 days by Finance Act 2020, and further includes citizen of India or Indian origin whose total income more than 15 lakhs other than income from foreign sources is considered as the resident if he is a stay in India 120 days in previous years and 365 days or more in preceding four previous years is considered as a residence as per recent amendment by Finance Act 2020. For the deemed concept of the deemed resident is also included in the residential provisions. The person, citizen of India or Indian origin, whose total income more than 15 lakhs, excluding income from foreign sources, and who is not considered the domicile or residence of other country, is considered as deemed resident. So these are changes covered by the Finance Act 2020, which next video with PowerPoint presentation. We cover all the concept, legal provisions, flow charts. This is very easily understandable by you. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much. Please watch my next video series for fast recapitulation level 1 video. This covers all the concepts in very precise manner, very short period, 10 minutes, 15 maximum 15 minutes, and recapitulating all the concepts in flowchart are easy to remember that concept. Thank you so much.